Hello students, welcome back to the chapter Sexual Reproduction in Flowering Plants. Students, today in this lecture we are going to discuss important concepts like vertical section of the ovule, development of the female gametophyte and the cellular organization inside the embryo sac. As we all know, ovule is a small structure which will be present attached to the placenta by means of the stalk called as a funicle. So, ovule is called as a female gametophyte, and if we take a vertical section of the ovule, we can see the structure similar to the diagram given in the slide. Ovule will be attached to the placenta by means of the stalk, and that stalk is called as a funicle. The point of attachment of the funicle to the body of the ovule is called as a hilum. Now, ovule contains an important part which is at the center, and that part is called as an embryo sac. So, it is a cavity where the egg will be present, which after fertilization will be converted into zygote, and thereby there will be development of an embryo. So, it is called as embryo sac. Embryo sac, since it contains a female gamete, that is egg, becomes an important part of the ovule. So, this embryo sac will be covered by protective coverings. The coverings are called integuments. There are two types of integuments present. The integument present outside is called as outer integument, whereas the integument present inside is called as inner integument. So there are two types of integuments present: outer integument and an inner integument. Outer and inner integument cover the full ovule but leaving one small area. So you can see here, this small area which is left without the integuments is called as a micropyle. Thereby the ovule becomes differentiated into two regions. The region near to micropyle is called micropylar pole, whereas the region opposite to micropyle is called as a chalazal pole. Now, next to the embryo sac, this portion will be made up of mass of undifferentiated cells, and those cells are diploid and are rich with a reserve food, and the cells are called nucellus. So this diagram, labeling and explanation can be asked for 5 marks. Embryo sac is called as a female gametophyte. Once again, let's brief the VS of the mature Anatropous ovule. If the diagram is asked in the exam, students, you have to draw how it is getting appeared in the slide. So, integuments are covered. Next to this green colored structure is a nucellus, and then there will be inside a embryo sac which is yellow in color. Okay, so just now we discussed the VS of the ovule. Embryo sac will be made up of cells like this. What are these and how many cells are there, that we are going to understand. The stalk of the ovule is called as a funicle. Then the body, this is the body of the ovule. Part of the funicle attached to the body of the ovule is called raphe. So, part of the funicle attached to the body. Then, a part where funicle attaches to the ovule is called hilum. Funicle attached to the basal part of the body at hilum. It gives a support, and also it acts as a projection and helps in the seed germination process. Nucellus is a central bulk of the ovule, which is also called as megasporangium proper, because one of the cell of the nucellus only will act as a functional megaspore mother cell. It is diploid and is made up of parenchyma cells, and the nucellus is the main site for this megasporogenesis. The region opposite to micropyle is called chalaza. It is the basal part of the nucellus where integuments, that is protective coverings, develop. It is called chalazal end of the ovule. There are two types of integuments present which are covering the embryo sac, and they are called integuments. Integuments are protective covering of the nucellus and embryo sac. They develop from the chalazal end. They completely surround the ovule, leaving one terminal end, and that becomes a micropyle. Usually, 90% of the angiosperms are made up of two integuments. So, if two integuments are there, then such a type of an ovule is called bitegmic. If there are only one integument, then it is called unitegmic. If there are no integuments, then it is called a tegmic. Now, these integuments provide protection to the nucellus and also to the embryo sac. So, outer integument and a inner integument. Now, we have understood that after the fertilization, the ovary develops into the fruit and ovules become what? Seeds. Then what happens to the protective coverings of the ovule, like outer integument and inner integument? Let's try to understand. Outer integument and inner integument after fertilization will be converted into. Outer integument becomes a testa, the outermost covering of the seed, which will be thick and will be resistant. Whereas inner integument of the ovule becomes a tegmen, which is a innermost seed coat, and this will be thin and transparent. The region where the integuments are not present is called micropyle. Integuments leave a narrow opening at the terminal end, and that is called micropyle. Micropylar end of the ovule it becomes, and micropyle is an important part because around 80-90% of the pollen tube will make their entry into the embryo sac through the micropyle. So it is the region for the entry of pollen tube. Now, let us try to understand a central tissue, that is embryo sac. As I said, it is also called as a female gametophyte because it contains a gamete called as an egg. Now, this embryo sac is said to be made up of 7 cells. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But it is made up of 8 nuclei, okay? So, to count the nuclei, you have to count the dotted structures, okay? Now, we'll count the 8 nuclei. They are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here are 2, 7 and 8. We are going to understand how come this embryo sac becomes 7-celled and 8-nucleated under a heading called as a development of the female gametophyte. Prior to that, the region where the egg is present, okay, that becomes a micropylar end, and the region opposite to micropyle is called chalaza, correct? Micropylar end contains egg cell and the synergids. Correct? Egg cell is also called oosphere, and the neighboring cells are called synergids. These 3 cells together makes egg apparatus of an embryo sac. Now, the region opposite to the egg apparatus or micropyle is called chalaza end, and that chalazal end contains 3 cells, and all 3 cells are called as antipodals. Now, antipodals, egg cell, and this central secondary nucleus, okay, which contains 2 polar nuclei, will be connected by means of plasmodesmata. So, this is called secondary nucleus. The embryo sac, which is present here, which is made up of 7 cells and 8 nucleus, is said to be monosporic. and also is said to be endosporic. It is, as we understood, seven-celled and is made up of 8 nucleus. So now we are going to understand the meaning of these 4 terms, that is monosporic, endosporic, seven-celled and 8 nucleated, by taking a detailed process of development of a female gametophyte. Now, if the embryo sac is showing monosporic character, endosporic, seven-celled and 8 nucleated characters, then that is called as a polygonum type, because for the first time the structure of such ovule was studied from the plant, called as a polygonum. Now, this is once again a vertical section of the ovule showing the parts like a funicle, raphe, hilum, nucellus, chalaza, integuments, micropyle, embryo sac, egg, synergids, antipodals and secondary nucleus. So this diagram can be asked for 5 marks. Now let us try to understand the advantage of the micropyle. So during the seed germination, the micropyle, which was not covered with the integuments, plays a major role, where water can enter easily and helps in the process of seed germination. Thereby we are able to see the development of the radical. Now, functions of the different parts of the ovule, let's try to understand. Embryo sac, this is a cavity called embryo sac, which is a female gametophyte. Female gametophyte contains an egg apparatus wherein we see synergids. Then what's the function of synergid? Synergids are made up of elongated thread-like structures called filiform apparatus. So this can be asked for 1 mark. Mention the function of filiform apparatus. The function of the filiform apparatus is they guide the pollen tube carrying 2 male gametes towards the egg. Okay. Now, 2 gametes are there in the pollen tube. This is the first gamete and this is the second gamete and this is the egg cell. The first male gamete is going to fuse with the egg cell, which are haploid, both are haploid. So the fusion is called syngamy. And after the fusion of the male gamete with the female gamete, the egg will develop into zygote. Okay, whereas 2 nucleus containing structure, that is secondary nucleus, will get fused with the another gamete, that is the second male gamete. Second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus and results in the formation of a triploid structure by name primary endosperm nucleus. The main function of this primary endosperm nucleus is it divides and results in the formation of an endosperm. The endosperm will be rich with the reserve food and that is going to nourish developing embryo. Zygote develops into embryo and primary endosperm nucleus, which can be abbreviated as PEN, develops into triploid structure called as an endosperm. Now, region opposite to an egg apparatus is called chalazal end, and chalazal end is made up of 3 important cells called as antipodals. Now, let us try to understand development of female gametophyte. So, as we have understood, students, this is a vertical section of the ovule where we can see a green colored portion, and that is called nucellus. There are 2 parts of the ovule which we can see. The part where the integuments are not present is called micropylar end, and the region opposite to that micropylar end will become chalazal end. 1 or 2 cells from the hypodermal region near the micropylar end will differentiate, which will be diploid, and will get differentiate and they start functioning as the archisporium initials. Archisporium initials divide mitotically to form sporogenous tissue and primary parietal cell. Parietal cells usually will help in the development of integuments actually, whereas the sporogenous tissue can also be called as archisporium cell, or archisporium cell only will behave as a sporogenous tissue and will divide by means of a meiosis. Now this archisporium is regarded as megaspore mother cell, and this megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division. As we know, students, there are four linear cells will be formed, which are called megaspores, which will be haploid in nature. Amongst four megaspores which are produced, okay, three are going to get degenerate. So this is a linear tetrad of a haploid megaspore. The process of formation of the haploid megaspores from the diploid megaspore mother cell is called as megasporogenesis. Now, the chalazal end is there, and the megaspore which will be facing the chalazal end, which is away from the micropyle, will become a functional megaspore. So, the functional megaspore can be called as farthest to the micropyle. Now, this functional megaspore which is there, that is regarded as a first cell of the female gametophyte. Now, this functional megaspore enlarges and develops into female gametophyte by undergoing repeated mitotic divisions. See here, what happens? Three successive planes of a free nuclear mitotic cell divisions takes place and results in the formation of a seven-celled, eight-nucleated embryo sac. Now, the megaspore has enlarged its size. See the movement, students. The nucleus of the megaspore divided mitotically, and two nuclei are formed, and these nuclei will move towards two poles, micropyle pole and chalazal pole. Further, the nucleus will divide in respective poles. Okay, this is a first mitotic division, and after that, once again, the egg has enlarged, that is the megaspore has enlarged in its size. Once again, the nucleus undergo mitotic division to form two more nuclei, and similarly, these two more nuclei, which are formed as a result of second mitosis, undergo third plane of a mitosis, resulting in the formation of how many? Four nuclei. After the formation of four nuclei in each pole, one nuclei from each pole will start migrating towards what? Center. So here you can see third mitosis has resulted in the formation of eight nuclei. One nucleus from each pole moves towards the center. See the movement. And these two nuclei are called as polar nuclei. Both are haploid in nature. What happens next then? This is a female gametophyte, which is called as an embryo sac. And this undergoes now cellular organization. So what happens now? Micropylar end three nuclei which are there, they undergo formation of cell wall around them, as you observed just now. Two red colored labeled that is diagrams which are there, they are synergids, and the green colored which is situated at the center is called as egg apparatus. Synergids will develop yellow colored structure, as you can see in this diagram, that is a vacuole, and finger like projections which are called as a filiform apparatus. Now the central cell, which is labeled in this diagram green in color, is called egg cell, and these three cells together will make an egg apparatus. Okay, now coming to chalazal end, the three nuclei which are there towards the chalazal end, they also develop a cell wall around them, and they get to differentiate into cells called antipodals, and the two polar nuclei which were there at the center, both of them get surrounded by one cell wall, and now this is called as a two polar nuclei or a central nucleus. Okay, central cell is with the two nuclei connected to egg. It will be connected to egg, and also it will be connected to the antipodals with the minute strands called as a plasmodesmata. Now this is a developed embryo sac which is having synergids, antipodals, egg and the polar nuclei will be present packed inside the structure called as a ovule. Okay, now yellow colored portion is called embryo sac. How many nuclei are there, students, in the embryo sac? Start counting now. There are 8 nuclei, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is 8 nucleated. How many cells are there? If you count cells, there are 7. How come? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So it is 7 celled. And then what? It has developed inside the megaspore or outside the megaspore? Just now we witnessed that the formation of the embryo sac took place inside the megaspore. It is called as endosporic, correct? And how many megaspores, functional megaspores, were there? Only one, because the 3 got degenerate. Correct, the 3 got degenerated, correct? So it is called as a monosporic. So such a type of a monosporic, endosporic, 7 celled, 8 nucleated embryo sac is termed to be a polygonum type of the embryo sac. What it is called? Polygonum type of the embryo sac. So students, in this video, we discussed about VS of the ovule. Also, we discussed development of female gametophyte and its cellular organization. Whereas in the next video, we will discuss important phenomena, and that is a pollination. Hope the contents of the video are clear. Thank you.